In this session, we are actually going to cover what exactly is the significance of Document ID and Document ID Service. But before I actually explain you this, let me show you. I have a shared documents in which I already have a file. Now I right click on the file, open in new tab, or let's say go to properties. I can now copy this URL, cancel. And this URL now I share it with my friend. Now what we have to actually note here is in the URL when ID is given, share documents batches 1.xls source and so and so. Now I go back, for some reason I change the name of the document. I edit the properties and I change the name of the file batches.xlsx. Now if I right click, go to properties, again copy this URL, just say Ctrl A, Ctrl C, OK, and paste here the URL. This time the file name has changed. So by any chance, if this was the file name I shared at some other location, maybe by email, maybe I have saved it in some other location as document URL, then the moment I change the name of the document is not anymore available. That means the URL of the document is file name dependent, and not only file name dependent, even path dependent. If the location changes and if the file name changes, the old URL will become out. I mean, old URL will become out of context and will not be anymore accessible. So this is really a concern in enterprise where the documents are not just referred at one place but at many places. Changing is a real big concern. So what is done? Yeah, the name of the document then would be replaced with ID. So how does it all work? Document ID capability is activated and managed at the site collection level. Now what we are going to do is for each and every document, ID is going to be generated. And there is a service called as Document ID Service, which is going to be activated at the site collection level, and this will be responsible for generating the document IDs. And yeah, the capability of the document ID service includes generating ID value and managing the ID service. IDs can be used to retrieve items independent of their current location. The ID service supports this process by generating and assigning the IDs to the document. That means no more the URL of the document or identity of the document is based upon the file name or the location path. Instead, it will be based upon the IDs which are assigned by the document ID service to the document. Once an ID is assigned, a static URL can be used to locate the document based on the ID. Static URL work correctly at the site collection level because the web browser manages the redirect before it invokes the specific offer client office client application. Basically what it means is automatically from a browser request will come based on ID, and then document ID service will be responsible for redirecting the ID to the appropriate location and the file name so that that is opened. The ID service generates ID for all documents in the site collection, but it does not generate ID for the other types like list items. List items don't have ID. It is only the documents which will have ID. IDs are generated every time a new document is created. The ID is required during the move operation. The ID is retained during the move operation, and a new ID is created when the document is copied. But by any chance, if you are copying the same document to another location, it will generate a new ID, but otherwise it is always going to retain the ID if you are just doing a move operation. So how to enable all these things? So go to site action, site settings, site collection feature, and there is here a document ID service which is at site collection level. Now activate this service. By default it is not activated, you'll have to activate this service. Once activated, now we can again go back to site actions, site settings, site collection. And here we'll have to now use document ID settings. document ID settings. Now, assign document IDs. Begin IDs with the following character. If you want, you can specify the initial characters to be given to the document. Now, let us say I give my company name. DSS is what I want to begin with. Specify whether IDs will be automatically assigned to all documents in the site collection. Additionally, you can specify a set of 4 to 12 characters. I need 4 to 12 characters. This is 3. We need one more. Let's say DSS1. 12 characters that will be used at the beginning of the IDs assigned for document in the site collection to help ensure that item in different site collection will never get same IDs. So in this site collection, all the documents are now going to begin with DSS1. Note, very important, a timer job will be scheduled to assign IDs to the documents already in the site collection. The moment we say enable here, we will have a timer job which is going to be started, and that will be responsible for assigning IDs to all the existing documents which are there. New documents, fresh ID will be assigned. Reset all document IDs in the site collection to begin with these characters. Yes, existing documents also should start with this ID. Specify which search scope will be used to look up documents using their IDs. You want to see all site, or you can create actually search scope, and within that particular scope only you can assign the IDs to the document. Now click on OK. This is going to activate a timer job which will be taking care of assigning the ID. Now managing document ID jobs. So for this we'll have to go to central administration. As it opens in background, we have to go to monitoring, review jobs, run document ID enable disable job for the appropriate web application, document ID assignment job for the same web application as it is in the previous steps. So go to monitor, review timer jobs, document ID. Assignment job. We are in demo site 80. Actually, I should have changed this name. Did not, but it's okay now. Document ID assignment job. First, document ID enable disable job. We can run the task immediately. And then again document ID assignment job. Job history. This is user profile, application server, running jobs, nothing. Scheduled jobs. Change, yeah, document ID assignment job. All these have been succeeded. Just wanted to show you that demo site 80 is referring to our URL only. How? Go to application management, manage application, and you see server 10,000. That's what is our application we are working with, and the name given is demo site 80. When it is created, actually we should give proper name so that confusion would not have been there. By mistake, I did not change this port number. Anyways, we called it as demo site, if you remember, in the beginning when we created the site application. Now go to select document library. Whatever document library we have been working with, we'll modify the view to add document ID to the list, which was not visible right till now. So let us go to website settings, document library, and here we will modify the view and we will include ID. Already we have modified by, we don't need actually. Click on OK. So now we have ID of the document. Let's add a new document. Click on OK. New document is added and an ID is given. This is the one which I just added. Now let me show you this document URL. Right click, properties, copy this now into Notepad as before we did. And then again go back, I want to rename it, edit properties, let's say 1, 2, 3, save it. Now again right click, properties, copy, OK, paste here. You will see that the basic URL is now having 4 as the ID. Yeah, though this is there, it doesn't really matter. This will also open that document. Let me copy this. Actually, that old URL is not there, but I can paste here and open the document. MS Word is taking time. Word not responding. Because, oh, it's not valid. Oh, something wrong. There seems to be a problem with the jobs may not have been scheduled. So let's go back to central admin, share documents, no job history. Now this time we can select in view web application and filter by server 10,000. That's our application. So we now see what are the different job definitions. Job ID enable disable. Click here. Click on run now. Running jobs, not there. Job history. Now check up if document ID enable disable has come here. Not yet. So again click on job history. Yep, document ID enable disable. Now go back to job definition. Document ID assignment job. Run now, schedule jobs, job history, document ID assignment job completed. So now go back to share documents, library, library settings. Oh, it's taking time. And then all documents, this time after that job has successfully run, this is what is the ID we are actually interested in, the document ID. Check this, we are not interested in this plain ID 1, 2, 3, 4. That is, we want document ID which is linked to the document. So this is going to be the fourth one. Now go here and we have this document ID. Right click, properties. This is what we will share with the user. So let me copy this document ID into Notepad. Not copy. Right click, copy, paste, cancel. Now change this, edit property, change this, click on save. Now check the document ID. Right click, copy and paste here. It is still the same. So before naming, after renaming, in either case the document ID is same. And not only that, we can share this with the friends, with the other parts, maybe in the lists and all, and it can be given here to open the document successfully. MS Word will open the document successfully. So that's how. It is always recommended to identify documents by their document IDs rather than by their location or path. Beautiful feature, very much used in the enterprise system where a lot of documents have to be moved around, renamed for whatsoever reasons. So this concludes our document ID service and ID usage session. Thank you.